That's what we're gonna give because you gave it to us. Forgiveness and love.
In the Bible, in Psalm 147:3, it reads, "He healeth the broken in heart and bindeth up their wounds." That is so important, to bind up the wounds in our heart. One day I went to the Lord because I have suffered many wounds in my past, and I needed a healing. And the Holy Spirit gave me this teaching, and I'm going to read it word by word because I don't want to change anything, because it was all given to me by the Holy Spirit. Like any pump, the heart requires fuel in order to work. The blood has to flow, but sometimes it can become blocked. If the heart could be changed as easily as a battery using a straight-edge screwdriver that jewelers use to open clocks and watches, whether the battery be just cleaned or removed, and a new one, restoring the working mechanisms, mending broken hearts could be very easy. Mending broken hearts is a risky thing. A heart that was just dumped by a sweetheart, or having the loss of a child for a parent must be very hard. Or worse still, a heart that stops when a heart attack happens. Whatever happens in life can affect your heart, like a loss in your business, or a failure of some sort, or not being able to get a job when you're qualified. Yes, if a heart could be easily changed or replaced as a battery, life could and would be great. Maybe only surgery or a spiritual healing of a heart that has been damaged by life's hurts and circumstances or lifestyle is the only option one may be given before it's too late. If learned, preventative options beforehand can be an alternative to treatments in later life. Maybe it could be just forgiveness of life's hurts that can prove to be beneficial to help you have a healthier heart. That could be an option. Have you ever investigated your heart to see if there's any unforgiveness? Just a thought. Because I have experienced repentance and forgiving all who've hurt me proved to be the most beneficial for having a healthy heart. It was impossible to accomplish this without pain and emotional stress, as the wounds were so deep and opened every time another hurt would happen.
That's what called to give, that's what you give to us right now. As you give us your forgiveness, we surrender because you are holy and merciful. We know you can forgive us of our sins and give us the grace to live holy lives. Lord Jesus, come into our lives. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Father, have mercy. All they need is you. All of my enemies that just want to use me and throw me away. Just join with me if you've never surrendered your life to Jesus Christ. Only He can give you peace. It's peace the world can't give. Just say, Lord Jesus Christ, come into my heart. I desire that you be the Lord of my life, so that I could be a child of the light, to know you as my personal Savior, for I know and believe that you died on the cross for my sins. You rose again on the third day, and you are coming again in glory. I believe in your forgiveness, and I desire that you help me to refrain from any temptations that would keep me separated from your everlasting love.
I'm asking you right now to close your eyes. Do the general healing. Merciful and loving God, ask your Holy Spirit to come in this place tonight. The same Holy Spirit that Jesus promised 2,000 years ago. The Holy Spirit that will be our advocate and guide and comforter. Lord God, touch each one of us here from head to toe. Many people here are suffering from excruciating pain in their bodies. Some having migraine, having headaches, brain cancer. They have a tumor in their brain. Lord, touch them right now. Some here, Lord, have a difficulty hearing. Their eyesight is fading. Touch their eyes and ears right now, O Lord God. Many people here, Lord, also suffer from sinus problem, from asthma, cannot smell, lost their sense of taste and sense of smell. Bless their gums and teeth. Lord God, touch them right now together. Bless their throat, their frozen shoulder, their back problem due to accidents, their shoulders, their arms. Bless their hearts too, Lord. The black arteries in their hearts. Those who have a cancer, Lord God, breast cancer, lung cancer, colon cancer, liver cancer, uterus cancer. Those who have problems with their kidneys, with their pancreas, with their ovaries, Lord God, bless each one of us here. If you're able to create us out of nothing, you can certainly recreate us, uproot in our bodies all unproductive cells, all the cancer cells that are growing, those who have a big cyst and lumps in their body, oh Lord God, those who have leukemia, Lord, bless them right now. Also, Lord, bless those who are in a wheelchair, those who suffer from stroke. Bless them right now. You know, Lord, their affliction and sicknesses. You love them, Lord. Also, Lord, bless those who have a hip problems, lower back problems, knee problems, heels and toes. Bless them right now. And especially, Lord, those who have so much anger in their hearts that needs forgiveness. Those relationships that are broken. Those who suffered from divorce, suffered from abortion. Those who cannot forgive themselves, Lord God, bless and touch their heart right now and give them hope. This evening, Lord, we're giving ourselves to you, our life and our whole being to you. So touch us and heal us as we ask the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Merciful and loving God, after knowing the intentions and petition that is in our hearts, we believe that you're also going to bless our Pope, all our bishops, our priests, our government officials. And we believe that you will listen and answer to all our prayers, for we ask this in the mighty name of Jesus the Lord.
Let your waterfall flow over me. Let me feel the warmth, the fresh presence of you.
Yes, Lord.